Hi everyone, today we'll take a look at post-processing of 3D prints. It means we will take a 3D printed model and turn it into a beautiful fully colored object. This is the best way how to create things you can put on display or how to make amazing cosplay accessories. So let us show you how to do it. Once the object is printed, you need to remove all supports and brims. Actually, it doesn't really matter from which type of filament you print or what color is used, because in the next steps you will cover the whole surface with another material or paint. However, the best options are PLA or PETG. Try to clean all parts from all strings and cut off all elephant feet from the print, otherwise you won't be able to align the parts perfectly. The printed model should be temporarily assembled first. An ordinary adhesive tape is perfectly fine for this task, and a tape is also useful once you get to painting. Let's say we will need to paint the model with multiple colors, and the tape can be used to mask various sections of the model so that the spray paint does not affect already painted parts. Once we know how the model will look and we know which parts will have to be glued together, we can finally start with the proper glue. We recommend using a glue with an activator, which usually comes as a spray. If you don't have that, any better super glue should be enough to ensure a strong connection. Large and thin surfaces can be reinforced with a polyester resin that improves the structural strength of the whole model. Add a hardener to the mixture according to the manufacturer's instructions. It's always better to start with a small amount so you don't have to throw the remaining material away. Also, keep in mind that the polyester resin will pretty much destroy the bowl and the paintbrush. Apply the mixture into the inside of the model with a brush. If you still find the model fragile, use a fiberglass cloth, which you will press into an already applied polyester resin layer and then apply another layer on top of it. The resin should be applied in a well-ventilated room or outdoors, but preferably at temperatures above 20 degrees Celsius. Now we have the models ready for the next step, hiding gaps between parts and sanding. First, let's do a rough sanding of the printed object to find out whether we need to add extra material to hide the gaps between different parts. It is also the first step in the process of creating a nice, smooth surface. For this task, we recommend the P100 grit sanding paper. Once the model has been roughly sanded, we can move on to filling the gaps between single parts. We recommend using a body filler used in the automotive industry. Apply a thin layer on the gaps and let it dry. Once the model has dried, polish it with a P100 sandpaper. Keep repeating this procedure until the gaps are no longer visible. Once the model is ready, we can apply a layer of a putty or a body filler onto the rest of the model and then sand it with a P100 sandpaper. And we basically repeat this step over and over and over again until the model is beautifully smooth. However, be careful not to make unnecessarily large scratches or gaps in the print, which would require extra fixes afterwards. On the other hand, if you just grind through the surface into the infill, don't throw the part away, you can still fix it easily with a putty. Between each round of application and sanding of body filler, it is a good practice to spray the model with a filler in a spray that will highlight contours between layers so we can instantly see whether there is some kind of bulge or defect. Use a marker to mark areas that have visible inconsistencies and require more care in the next round of sanding, smoothing, or painting. You don't have to worry that alcohol-based markers would be visible through the base color and multiple layers of the filler. When the model is finally dry, you will easily mask these marks with the first proper color layer. Once we have sanded everything to achieve the best possible look, the model needs to be sprayed with a base paint and then finished with a very fine P400 grit sanding paper to achieve a completely smooth surface, which is ready for applying the last layer of base paint. If you feel that the surface is still not smooth enough, you can spray the model with a filler or a base coat again and then sand it with a P400 grit sandpaper, either using dry or wet sanding methods. Use the spray from a distance of about 20 centimeters, which is 8 to 10 inches, at an angle of about 15 degrees. This applies to base colors or colorless varnishes as well. Use smooth, long strokes and spray the model from one end to the other without staying in one place for too long. This will avoid accumulation of drops of paint. Now we have the base paint applied, so we can finally move on to the other colors. The best way to apply the paint is to start from the least accessible places or from the largest areas. A good practice is to fix every layer of paint in place using a clear coat spray, glossy or matte, to preserve the layer and prevent any damage to it, such as smudging, during subsequent work. Then you can proceed with applying other colors, either with a brush, airbrush or spray. If you use a brush, keep in mind to mix the color with enough water to avoid visible brush strokes on the surface of the object. Apply multiple layers to achieve proper coverage. The color will be beautifully saturated and the brush marks will not be visible. If you apply paint using a spray or an airbrush, you may need to use a paper adhesive tape to mask already sprayed surfaces. With regard to color selection, brands like Vallejo, Citadel or Model Air will offer you a huge range of shades. Maybe you already have your favorite brands, but we know from our own experience that it's good to do a bit of experimenting from time to time and discover new products. Once you get to gluing, it may happen that you encounter parts that will be stressed more. To achieve a better toughness, we can reinforce the stressed parts to prevent them from breaking. The best practice is to use metal profiles and drill small holes in the plastic where we can insert the profiles. You can use various screws, pipes or wires, skewers or plastic boards as a reinforcement profile, or pretty much any material or objects that will fit the particular model and improve the strength of the stressed part. So, for example, this antenna required reinforcing because this part was too thin and susceptible to fracturing. We fixed that by drilling a small hole and inserting a steel rod in it. And this concludes our video. We took a 3D printed object and through the process of sanding, gluing, painting and coating, we turned it into something you can wear or put on display. Also, don't forget about one of the biggest advantages of 3D printing. If you accidentally damage the model, you can easily print another one. So don't worry about something like I'm clumsy, I would ruin it, because with a 3D printer, you can always try again. So, thank you for watching, and remember, if you want to learn more about post-processing and other techniques, be sure to check out our blog at prusaprinters.org.